Okay, so in this video, we're going to do a quick look at the new K40 diffusers, their latest and greatest G5 version. And so the K40 is the head sitting on the right. It's the larger head, looks like this. And you can see it's nice long head. Well, not nice, not a good thing necessarily, but it's got screw-in holes here so you can mount it right on your plate. And then you've got the CPU here, which very standard. This is the brains that all the heads would plug into, tells it how to operate and all. You can see it's a four-head system, got room for four heads there, and then the power/control plug right there. So no other plugs, just four heads and the host port. Now the other set of jammers that I've got here are the Blinder HP905s. I just got a new car, so I pulled these out of my old car and installed the ALPs in my new one. So I've got these sitting around now in my living room. And just kind of handy to have them around before I sell them. But if you take a look, you'll see first and foremost the head is much, much smaller than the K40 head. If you take a look at them in comparison, you'll see that, I mean, world of difference. Like the Blinder heads, the HP905s are so much smaller. So one, two and a half to almost three times smaller. They're also a little bit more narrow this way. And I'm like totally not watching the screen, so. Okay, and then you can see the receiver diode is right here. The K40, they got some name for it as far as having five receivers there. The Blinder receivers are right here under the bubble. The Blinder transmitting diode is gonna be right there. And then the LEDs that transmit in the K40 are gonna be in there. And in just a second, we'll go ahead and plug in the K40, and I'll show you the unit in operation. Okay, so we've got the K40 set up. They are powered on, they're wired in, and I'm gonna go ahead and shoot them with a laser gun, and you're gonna hear it activate. And then you'll see the LEDs there light up on the left-hand side. Let's see if it does it again. There they are. And then I do think they might be set up by default to automatically kill after 10 seconds. I was doing some testing before I shot this video and I was noticing that kind of effect. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn off the lights. And this is gonna be nice because now the camera adjusts real quick and it makes everything a lot more sensitive. So you should actually be able to see the LEDs glow a lot better now that the camera's compensating, and it's just gonna make everything brighter. So. Let's see if the jammers are going to go ahead and reactivate for us. There they are. Let's see if it does a 10-second JTK. Yep. Okay, so it does look like after about 10 seconds or so, the heads do automatically shut off. The beep does keep warning you. It's pretty loud on this thing. It does keep warning you that you continue to be shot, and then maybe a fraction of a second after you stop shooting, the beeping stops. But the heads that you can see, it is a series of LEDs in there, and they do operate for 10 seconds. And then, let's go ahead and turn this back on. There we go. We'll adjust this. So you can see it definitely does respond to the PL3. I'm testing with the Pro Laser 3 here. And yeah, the LEDs turn on and fire back. So good news there, definitely does work and respond to the gun. LEDs are, at this point, older technology. They have, by and large, in most other jammers, been replaced by laser diodes. Not light-emitting diodes, but specifically laser diodes. And I forget at this point the reason why that's been done. More powerful or something, I forget what. But yeah, the idea is LEDs are kind of outclassed at this point. They've been replaced by the diodes because the diodes are just better technology. So if you see what's used in the laser interceptors, what's used in the Blinder HP905s, it's used in the ALPs. Escort used to use their ZR4s with the diode or the LEDs, and they have switched now to the Laser Shifter Pros, which are based on the laser interceptors. So Escort has recently switched from LEDs to diodes. The older Blinders, the M27s and the M47s, were LEDs, and people were asking them, please, please, please switch to diodes. And then the Blinder HP905s were released that used diodes and performed much better. The K40s are still using LEDs, which I'm guessing is probably one of the key reasons why it performs so poorly in testing that people have done, like real-world testing, mounted on a car, and it doesn't perform as well as some of the other jammers. I'm guessing there's other things going on, especially with some of the LiDAR guns that have jammer or anti-jam capabilities. I'm guessing this one is not the most capable at actively being able to jam these guns. We are going to have to do some testing, and we do have some testing coming up to test the capabilities of this unit on a car and against some guns that are specifically designed to defeat laser jammers, so that is going to be coming up. But this is just a quick look at the unit itself to see it in operation and just get familiar with the K40 G5 Laser Diffuser, which is just another word for jammer. Escort calls it shifters, most people call it jammers. In K40 land, they call it a diffuser. Okay, and then in this third part of the video, what we're going to go ahead and take a look at is the jamming pattern coming out of the K40 head here. And basically what we're going to do is we've got our good old custom Pro Laser 3 here, and what we're going to do is we're going to first shoot the LiDAR gun into this receiving diode here, and this is going to show us on the iPad the pulse pattern that's coming out of the laser gun. Then we're going to take this this jammer head, we're going to put it over there as well, and then we'll see the jamming response pattern that's coming out of it. So first, let's go ahead and get rid of the head, and we're going to shoot the LiDAR gun itself. So let's start with that. There we go. There's the pattern. It's kind of tiny. I can magnify it a little bit. I do have some noise here from my my AC adapter, so you can ignore that. But there you go. There's the pulse pattern coming out of the Pro Laser 3. It is a 200 pulses per second gun, so there it is. The LED is going to be a little bit more powerful coming out of the K40, so I'm going to zoom out a little bit. And then next, what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and take this head, and we're going to place it right over here, and now you'll get to see what the K40 does. There you go. There you go. So that's a look at the pulse pattern coming out of this, and as you can see, it is matched to the Pro Laser 3. Same pulse rate coming out there. The pulses are more powerful than what's coming out of the laser gun, but we're not trying to overpower the gun. We're just trying to confuse it. So as you can see, yep, it does work. And that's just a quick look at the K40 here operating on an oscilloscope and seeing that, you know, it actually does work. And there you go. That's what it does. So there is going to be some controlled testing coming out here soon from one of the testing groups within the community, so stick around, stay tuned, and you'll get to see how this unit performs against a whole variety of guns in the real world. So, thanks for watching.